Greetings, Eric Backer. Thanks for catching up with me and thanks for looking at my channel. I always appreciate people viewing the work that I do. That's great. We're going to talk about calcium oxalate stones or kidney stones. These are the most common form of kidney stones. So you may know someone who's had a kidney stone, or you know, you may be watching this yourself because you've got kidney stone problems and want to know a bit more about it. So let's talk a bit about that topic today. I might break this down into a couple of videos because otherwise it's going to get too long. So calcium oxalate stones, what are they? Well, the kidneys are quite remarkable organs. We've only got two of them, and they sit in the lower back. Sometimes when people have a back problem, they in fact have a kidney problem, you know, and vice versa. So if in doubt, you need to get that checked out by your doctor. But the kidneys are really hard-working organs, incredibly hard-working. They filter about 25% of the blood that your pumps every hour. They work really hard. They make sure that the electrolyte balance is kept really good in the blood. So basically, they're going to regulate a lot of minerals there and also regulate the fluid balance. The kidneys also make a hormone called erythropoietin, I think it's called, which is responsible for red blood cell production. So the kidneys perform a whole bunch of different tasks in the body, far too many for me to talk about in this video. But they're basically filtration organs. They're like the liver. They keep you in great shape by filtering your blood and getting all the crap out of there. So the kidneys filter out aluminum, mercury, you know, all the different chemicals that you eat, you know, that you're getting through your diet or through your air or through your beverages. Kidneys have got to clean all that stuff out. It's incredible how hard they work. So what are these stones and why do they form? Well, if you think about it, the kidneys will pick up anything that's in the bloodstream. They'll filter the blood. Anything that's in the blood, it's going to go into the kidney. It's going to stay in the kidney or get passed out through the urine. So if you think about it carefully, calcium oxalate. So this is calcium, which forms, you know, a combined deposition with either oxalic acid or phosphate. So about 10% of kidney stones are made from uric acid. And this is more common in guys. Women can have it too. But guys tend to also be more prone to kidney stones, I think, a few times more than women do in general. Could be because of their diet or the lack of water or too much coffee, tea or alcohol. But there's a couple of foods I want you to be careful of if you want to avoid calcium oxalate stones, or if you've got stones, not to have any more or create bigger stones. So, and these foods contain oxalic acid, so you need to be a little bit careful. I've got a bit of a list here. I'm just going to read out a few foods that you need to be cautious of. Beetroot, rhubarb, watercress, spinach, Swiss chard or silver beet, chocolate is another one, and amaranth. You might have heard of amaranth. So a lot of these foods belong to the Chenopodiae family. It's a particular family of vegetables that have these like seeds on them. In fact, if you grow beetroot like I do and you let it come to seed, it's not. It doesn't look dissimilar to amaranth, which is quite interesting. So you need to be careful with these high oxalate foods. I had a patient several years ago with multiple kidney stones. In fact, her husband had kidney stones as well. And when I inquired to her about her diet, she said the only vegetable she was eating was Swiss chard. She ate it twice a day. She grew it all around the house. She had this raised vegetable garden built right around the house. And when I inquired further into the vegetable garden, it was just basically all green lumber. It was copper treated copper treated pine they put in the ground. They built these beds up. And they grew Swiss chard in it. And I said, well, you might want to consider using older wood, you know, without creosote or junk in it, or, you know, New Zealand hardwood, which is clean. So get rid of that other stuff there, that other timber, which could be suspect, and don't just grow Swiss chard. You need to grow other kind of vegetables like broccoli and celery and things like this. So, but this woman was having pain in the joints, pain in the lower back, and she had kidney stones. So, you know, it may be a link there. So if you're eating a lot of these kind of foods, you may want to, you know, think carefully about that. You can get rid of calcium oxalate stones, but it can take a lot of time. And naturally, it's not that simple to do. Some people say drink lots of apple cider vinegar. You know, there are other tricks that you can do as well. There are many different herbs you can take. But the problem is, once you've got the stones and they're very painful, you want to get something done instantly. I had kidney stone myself in my 20s when I was going to the gym. I drank far too much cow's milk. Like I remember, I was drinking liters of cow's milk all the time. I ended up with horrific kidney stone pain, in my groin area. It went down sort of the thigh and in my lower back, and I ended up passing it out. But I wouldn't wish that pain on anybody. It's a terrible pain, absolutely awful pain to have. So if you've got a kidney stone and you've had pain associated with it, I know how you feel, because it's not something I would really like anyone to have. So that's it for this video. I'm going to talk in another video more about the treatment, about what you can do, and other aspects, you know, of this particular condition. But just be mindful of those vegetables, because they can be stone producers. Chocolate's a big one. Coffee's a big one. My granddad had a whole jar of kidney stones he showed me when I was a young boy. And then years later, when I studied medicine, I realized why granddad got the kidney stones. Because like a lot of Dutch granddads, or Dutch people, particularly his generation, granddad was drinking between 10 to 15 cups of coffee per day. And it was the filtered coffee. His house always smelled strongly of coffee. So when you drink lots and lots of coffee, if you think about it, coffee has an ability to really cause problems in the body. Coffee also helps to leach out calcium from the bones, and you are more prone to osteoporosis if you're a heavy coffee drinker. And I believe that the very heavy coffee consumption led to granddad's kidney stones, which he proudly showed me the scar on his back when he had to get the kidney cut open. So there you go. There you have it. Don't drink too much coffee. Watch out for these oxalic acid containing foods. Catch up with me in the next video, and I'll talk a bit more about kidney stones. Thanks for tuning in.